is obviously being talked about everywhere, and the latest thing, well, relatively latest thing, is the GPT Store, which is an app store for ChatGPT bots that people have designed and created. Today's video, we are going to hone in on five of them that you can use to enhance your productivity. So if you're new here and you like software, you like apps, do subscribe. We'd love to have you as a regular viewer, but without further ado, let's dive into the list. Before we begin, if you're more interested in the privacy and data side of this, I've actually put a little excerpt at the back of this video that you can skip to in the timestamps about how ChatGPT uses your data, just so you know that you feel happy and secure before using these. And the first GPT recommendation is Calendar GPT, which is essentially a way to plug in your calendar using their plugins with Zapier and essentially ask ChatGPT things like, what's on my schedule today? This is a great way to access your Google Calendar through ChatGPT through a secure and reliable partner, which is Zapier.com. So it's worth checking this one out as one of the top recommendations. So next up is GPT number two is toolfinder. Toolfinder is our productivity tool store, a place to find productivity apps for anyone who's searching for a wide variety of situations. This is going to be the place. So you can use the GPT to ask questions like best project management app for small businesses or best to-do list app for minimal use cases, and it'll come up with the best recommendation using all our knowledge and resources over on Toolfinder. And naturally, go get an advantage in finding that productivity tool for you. GPT number three is called Consensus, and this is a AI research tool that scans over 200 million academic papers and gets science-based answers back. It allows you to also draft content with accurate citations. You can ask it anything like, does fish oil improve your mood, and use certain studies, and it'll pull the best recommendations out there. GPT number four is one called Gym Streak Workout Creator. This is created by a site called gymstreak.com, and it's great for enhancing your workout and having a conversation-like mode with a expertise, particularly in building gym workouts. This could be really helpful for making sure you're tailoring your gym workout to something like weight loss, or maybe even to a specific type of muscle. And obviously all of that insight is from their website. So it is obviously a provider that has their own app, but it allows you to get some insights that could helpfully improve your workout and that back and forth communication. Our final recommendation, and GPT 5 on our list, is one called Books, and it's an AI guide to the world of literature and reading. This is great for recommending new books that might be useful. And in particular, it could be quite helpful for narrowing down non-fiction books as well. For example, if you're looking for a particular book in productivity or something that might crush a use case, for example, you could ask it like, I'm looking for a book that is helping me to improve business efficiency and enhance productivity every day. And I can imagine it will come up as a selection like Company of One, written by Paul Jarvis, which is a fantastic read to help improve your efficiency of your business, making sure you don't have too many weight on your shoulders. This is a really interesting read if you're looking for nonfiction and literature books to help you enhance picking and choosing which one's right for you. Now, the GPT Store is fairly new and it's growing, so I can imagine there's gonna be loads more in the future, especially when the plugin side of stuff come much further. But those are my five picks, my recommendations for you to check out. And obviously there's tons more on the GPT Store. You can find all of those apps listed below. But before we go, let's talk a little bit about the security aspect of this. So GPT states that the data collection for this in their messages and responses basically are collected and stored by OpenAI, the company behind this application. Now, essentially, this helps to improve the model. And in the example, they'll use these model answers and questions to enhance and improve the model that they're working on. They also state that OpenAI tries to keep your data private and anonymous. And this means that they try not to let anyone know where the data came from. However, it's a good idea not to share very private or sensitive information. And obviously the main use of the data is to enhance the GPT models. So obviously that's something to be aware of when using ChatGPT in general, which I think a lot of people are these days. Anyway, folks, I hope you enjoyed this recommendation. If you're new to the channel, do subscribe, check out all the GPTs in the recommendations below, and I'm sure we'll cover AI apps in the future, many more. So I will see you all in a future video, and I hope you have a fantastic day ahead. Cheerio.